Amy, how are you feeling, young lady?
Life's a little bit crazy, but I'm missing the house so much.
You were sort of kind of... You just said to me, I'm kind of welling up.
Yeah, I was a bit out there.
And you were close to our lovely
prefab. Don't start me off again.
Why is that? Because you're only in there for 2 weeks.
Honestly, 2 weeks, I know, and it's so intense. But I had so much fun, you can't imagine. Constant play fights, water fights, pool parties. It's going back to being a big kid again. It's
okay.
Fantastic.
On Friday night, 58% of the public vote, you gave a candidate the ninth person to be evicted. Our cameras are there to follow the return to the real world. We'll have a chat after you take a look at this.
OK.
Tonight, Lamy joins Chiggy on Heartbreak Hill. Amy's coming out!
It wasn't very long.
It's gone so quickly. I was kind of shocked by a few of the comments that those that nominated me made. They were quite harsh. Tracy and Carol at the time were very harsh.
Ladies and gentlemen, Amy!
Obviously, your relationship with Liam yielded quite a bit of animosity between some of the other housemates. Could you just sort of answer it once and for all? How far did you go with him? And
you know, you guys know what you saw. I had fun. That's what I went there for. And that's all you're going to get. I'm off now and I'm going to get some sleep for the first time in about 2 weeks. So, bye guys, miss you all, love you lots and can't wait to see you and see you all soon. Bye!
There we go. Now then, let's get cracking. That's the first time we've ever seen anyone deliberately say when they're in a press conference, that's all you're getting. What did you mean by that? Is that like keeping the powder dry for the old...
No, Liam and I, people didn't see, we talked about things so much and just said, it's just a bit of fun while we're in the house. It's not going to be a big deal. So as far as I was concerned, I didn't want to make it a big deal at any point ever. We trusted each other that we both, were, you know, were on the same level with it, so...
So that's what you meant. We've got the Remanda memorial up here at the moment.
Remanda.
But we had a Lamy one earlier on.
Did you?
Yeah, and it went kind of frosty and hot very, very quickly. Did you go into the house, were you a fan of Big Brother, or did you go in because you wanted the publicity for the job you were doing?
In previous years, I've watched it and stuff, and I've been a fan, but I went in because I just thought it looks like a hell of a lot of fun.
Really, truthfully?
Truthfully, 100%, which is why, like I say, I'm missing the play fights and the
water
fights.
Not for the old wanger shots?
No, not for the old wanger shots.
OK. There was a lot of booing on Friday night. Did you expect that reaction from the crowd, Ames?
I thought it'd be worse, to be honest.
Did you? Why?
Really did. I'm always the kind of person that people, you either love me or you hate me.
Yeah. Do you get on better with boys or girls? Because you seem like a guy's girl.
Yeah, I'm a bit of a ladette with that kind of stuff. I do, generally. They say what they think and they get on with it, and that's a lot easier to deal with, I think.
Yeah, OK. Now, you denied having a game plan, but your fellow housemates and a lot of viewers thought you did. Why do you think that was?
I think because I was quite confident from the moment I got in there, but that's just the way I am about things. You know, I didn't really know much about anybody. Mm. You can't avoid knowing who's in there and, you know, seeing anything about them because it's life, it's around us all the time. But I really hadn't watched anything before going in, so...
Because when I was watching it, I thought what you did was what I think I would do if I was a halfway housemate, in that the minute you get in, you think, OK, I know these people, that friendship in a weird way is banked. If I'm going to get on with everyone in this house, I've got to get to know everyone really quickly.
Yeah.
And I think they sort of resented that, and obviously, the old housemates
so
are quite a tight-knit group
yeah,
as well.
Yeah, they were. It was so hard, but I walked through that door and, you know, from the diary room into the main house, and the twins just dived on me and took me outside. Mm. And I was, like, instantly just comfortable with them, Brian and Liam. And I thought, well, OK, you know, do this. I thought, if I force myself to talk to everybody and make a conversation, it just looks fake and that's not me. It's not what I want to do, so...
OK, we tried to figure out whether, indeed, you had a game plan or not. All we could come up with was this. Take a look.
Do you think Amy has a game plan?
Yeah. I'm not with him, God damn it!
It might be a flipping idea just to go and cool for a couple of days,
like. It's fine.
Tell us a
I don't like talking about people behind their back, but he's doing my head in. They've got nothing that says they should stay in there over the originals.
Some of the first things she was saying were very negative things about her co-halfway housemate.
I just kind of can't trust her.
If you're going to make your decisions, fine. At least stand by them. Don't try slithering back when it's done. Yeah.
I can't help that I have large breasts.
I think she was probably prepared to do anything she needed to do to be noticed. And I think, to that end, it's probably backfired a bit.
Now, looking at that and the reactions of the housemates and so forth, do you think you can see why people thought you had a game plan?
Yeah, because everyone in the house seemed to, so I suppose people were going to take it that at the time they knew me better than anyone else, so they were going with it. But I'm just the way I am. I'm just very open about
looking
things,
at that,
I think,
I mean,
that's tripped me up.
I think the one thing, if you don't have a game plan, the one thing that shows you is how paranoid the house can get. Do you get
big
a sense,
time.
Do you get a sense of that when you're in there?
Yeah, there's a lot. And the minute anything changes, you know, even if it's that the weather's suddenly changed outside, it's to the point of what's going on. Twice.
Hey, they're powerful, they're not that powerful.
But twice, Brian went, I'm sure they're controlling it. Yeah, well, the sky, you know.
Yeah, well, Brian is a law unto himself. Jonty said that if the new housemates had stuck together a bit more, you'd have more power in the house. Do you agree with that?
No.
Why?
I don't. Because we'd only known each other, you know, 4 or 5 days when we had to make those decisions of who was going to go on which side of the house. Mm-hmm. We didn't know each other that well, you know. There was still a lot I found out about people after they'd left and things, and once we were all living together,
so... You didn't feel like you were tight enough, essentially.
I don't think we would have done too
If you'd have gone in at the start of the series, do you think you would have done better?
I think I would have had more of a chance to get to know people and they would have seen more of me than just what they thought.
Sure, sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you. When you go in as a halfway housemate, do you immediately think, I'm not going to win this?
I never wanted to win it, so, yeah, I wanted to have fun in there, but I think they're... You know, they are such a tight-knit group and they're a family. They're not just a group, they're a family in there now. And therefore, they don't really want to make changes to it if they can help it. They're not unwelcoming because that makes life awkward for everybody. But to get, you know, become a part of that, you've got to have been there from the start because they've been through so much that, you know, how can you be otherwise?
Yeah, OK. I mean, we have to talk about Liam a little bit. You said you were fine when he put an end to the whirlwind romance. Were you really? Because you did exactly what
yes.
I would do, going, yeah, no, it's fine, it's fine, it's fine. It turns around again.
No, but this is the thing. It wasn't a whirlwind
yes,
romance.
It was. You kissed and cuddled. I've had I call that's a girlfriend in my book.
And you're a bunny boy.
Okay. Now, you told me you thought Liam would help you if to be accepted by the other housemates. Is that part of the reason why you got close to him? I'm just saying that you'd get close to anyone if you knew they were popular.
No, I got close to him because I naturally found it really easy to get on with him. He's exactly like a lot of my lad mates out here, so... But I did kind of think that he might encourage them to see the better side of me.
Yeah.
I don't know whether he did or not, so...
And one last question. Who do you think wants it in there the most?
I don't really know.
Do you think anyone's playing a particular game to try and win this show? Because now we're getting to the, you know, the business...
If I had to choose anyone, I'd say Carol.
Really? Why?
Because... She's so controlling. She says what goes. If you want to eat an egg and she tells you you can't, you put it down again. Everybody's equal.
To be fair, though, she's the only one that seems to do any cooking or cleaning.
Other than the time she was locked away for the task and me, Cara and the girls did a roast dinner for the whole family.
Yeah, you're breaking up, sorry. and who do you think will win?
Brian or the twins,
okay.
And I don't really mind
Audience?
Either way.
Brian. Actually, no one wants the twins to win over there.
That's cool by me if it's Brian, because he's
Brian's
a legend. Cool.
Do you think Brian's, you know, obviously Brian's big favourite out here at the moment, do you think Brian's aware that he's the favourite?
Not at all.
Really?
Not at all, no.
He is in for a shock of his life. Who do they think's the favourite in there?
I think they think the twins are a strong favourite, but Carol, they're all supporting Carol as well, because she's done so much for them, which she has, I can't take that from her. So I do think that they, you know, think she's going to be with a strong
With Carol, is your view slightly coloured because of, you know, to be fair, because the quite direct things
I wanted to get on with her, even after I knew she didn't particularly like me, so I wanted to make the effort, and I made the effort in a natural way without, you know, I didn't want to go up to her and say, you don't like me, what's the problem? I thought, she'll just get to know me. And the more I gave that chance, the less she actually bothered with me. So in the end, I thought, well, give up, it's not working.
Brilliant, listen, thanks for being so honest. Amy, everyone. Thanks, Amy.